much uncertainty surrounding the reopening of schools, there's concern growing over children who are skipping kindergarten.
Some districts have reported a sharp decline in enrollment. In this Learning Curve report, News 8's Shannon Handy looks into the numbers and the impact experts say it can have.
Carlo and Marcella, in California, kindergarten isn't mandatory, so we're finding that a lot of families are just choosing to opt out. In San Diego Unified, for example, the largest group not enrolled this year falls in transitional kindergarten or kindergarten grade levels.
Kind of all of the options have been on the table for us.
Holly Amaya has two kids, a second grader and a four-year-old, scheduled to start kindergarten this fall. Her hope is by then, San Diego Unified will be offering in-person classes, but with so much uncertainty, she's looking into alternatives just in case.
We've looked at, you know, parochial schools. We've looked at private schools. She needs to be in person someplace.
While Holly is doing everything she can to ensure her daughter will have a normal kindergarten experience, other families are forgoing it altogether. As of mid-September, San Diego Unified reported a decline of 1,682 transitional kindergarten or kindergarten students this school year. That represents 2 out of 3 of all unenrolled students district-wide. The state's largest district, Los Angeles Unified, reported losing 6,000 kindergarten students.
We've seen a lot of school districts facing the same problem with drops in enrollment.
Poway Unified spokesperson Christine Pike says the district saw its biggest enrollment drop this year in kindergarten as well, with 147 fewer students compared to last year. She believes that number would be more if not for the homeschool program Poway Unified offers.
And so because we had that option for families who did not choose in-person or who did not choose fully virtual, we actually were able to keep a lot of our Poway Unified students, especially the younger ages. And so our homeschool program went from maybe 3 dozen families enrolled in a normal year to 1,000.
While Poway Unified does offer in-person classes, Christine acknowledges starting kindergarten in virtual or hybrid settings isn't ideal, yet she and experts agree it's better than skipping it altogether.
The importance of kindergarten is really not just the academic portion where they're learning their words and their numbers, but the socialization process. You want all those things in place for students to have that foundation to know what to do in a classroom before they're diving into the academics.
Experts worry without kindergarten, first grade will be challenging for some kids. Now, earlier in the fall, San Diego Unified Superintendent Cindy Martin said those early grade levels are critical. She went on to encourage families to enroll their children in kindergarten, and other districts have shared that same message.